Andrew Watson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another masterclass. This time, I have a number of really good left and right hand exercises that you can do to help you get a lot better at both accuracy and control. Now, these are technical areas that players constantly have to maintain, so daily guitar technique routines will need to become habit if they aren't already. The reason is that the level of skill a guitar player has for technical coordination allows for an easier performance of songs and solos and rhythm playing. So the studies that we'll cover here need to become a part of your practice schedule, and once they are, it won't take long to start seeing some positive results from them in your playing. So let's not waste any time. We'll zoom in on the neck and get started with the first few exercises. Okay, an example one we're going to do here is start with some 2 and 3 string picking drills. This is great for developing good coordination between left and right hands, and it's just good for stamina too as you're playing through a part, you know, so you can really get it together and be able to hold your own, you know, as the idea is just, you know, propelling its way along the guitar fingerboard. First thing I want to do though is I want to get you acquainted with what's happening in our first drill. This is going to be example number 1A. I've organized a 2-string drill here between the third and second string sets. So let's go through it. It's written on the page at the fourth position. So we're starting at 4th fret 3rd string, moving up 4, 5, and 7 on that string, then moving over one position, jumping up a position, going 5, 6 on the next string over 2nd string. We're moving over again to the 7th fret of the 3rd string, then we're going to the 5th string fret of the 2nd string again, and the 5th fret over across on the 3rd string. And then what we're going to do after that is grab the 7th fret on the 3rd string, but jump back and then come around again to the same 3 notes that we had started on. So altogether, this thing is written in 2-4 time. It's written as 16th note triplets. So we're doing this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's a 2-part feel because we're in 2-4 time. 1, 2. Just like that. So you want to organize everything first, understand how this thing feels on the neck, really practice it to a good level in position. I'll go slow it down a little bit. That's where you should start. And just build it up to a good sense of speed for yourself. Now, another thing that's really important with these drills is to move them along the neck laterally. So you may want to dump it down there to the first position and just work from that position, build the pattern. What I was doing there, I was just going upward fret by fret and moving the shape along the guitar fingerboard that way. It's a great exercise. It can take a little bit of time, you know, it might be 3 minutes or something before you can just, you know, go across the entire length of the neck, but it's an excellent exercise and one I'd highly recommend doing. You know, do this for a while so it feels really comfortable. But I want to move on though to example number 1B. This one is going to involve 3 strings, and we're having this written out on the page coming from the 4th string at the 7th fret, and it's going to be really straightforward. It's actually, I think, an easier study than the first one, but we're just going to be moving through 7, 9, 7, 9, 7, 8, going from 4th string to 2nd string, and then we're going to come from the 10th fret of 2nd string and then descend, coming back around there. So we're going 10, 8, 7 on the 2nd string, 9, 7 on 3rd string, and we're finishing up on this tone here at the 4th string, 9th fret. So again, it's in 2-4 time. We're dealing with these 16th note triplets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we're just going up the pattern of a pentatonic, a little bit of a scale tone run in there. And, you know, it's the exercise right there. And the same kind of thing applies, you know, just take it all along the neck, work laterally with it. If you wanted to, you could just, you know, you could do the opposite of what we had done before. We were sort of building upwards with last study. This one, you could maybe drop it down, you know. And just just kind of work it along the neck that way. Excellent exercise, really good workout, and you know, you can start with those are really nice with the 16th note triplets and all that. But we're gonna take a short break, come back in a moment, and we're gonna take a look at 4 and 5 string picking drills. The Blues Guitar Styles ebook is a masterclass course covering a huge amount of information on the blues style. With 8, 12, and 16 bar blues progressions, classic blues styles, plus all the important chord patterns. There's over 50 pages of information, including sections on blues techniques like slide, alternate tuning, and bending. This ebook has everything the guitar player needs for a solid foundation in blues guitar, including 27 MP3 audio tracks for easy at-home study. Blues Guitar Styles is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. All right, so in example 2, we're going to be moving over to working with 4 and 5 string picking drills. Now, I got to warn you, it gets very difficult moving into such a larger span of guitar strings. So take your time with this. Do not rush this stuff. If you feel like you get any hand pain or things start to hurt when you're doing the exercise, take a break. Just stop. Go do something else for a while. Come back. Never, ever, ever play with pain. Big mistake. Bad idea. All right, let's run through this. Now, in example 2, we're going to branch out further, of course, with more guitar strings, and our result will be obviously a greater challenge of the picking of the notes. And we're going to start off in example number 2A with a drill that begins off of the 4th guitar string. It's written from the 4th to the 1st string, starting at the 5th fret on the 4th string. So I'm just going to work through this with you. It's a very minor-oriented idea. It's going to be using straight time 16th notes, again in 2-4 time signature. So there's a little bit of sequencing in it. We're kind of running up some scale tones to start with. And after that, we're sort of going in a little bit of a pentatonic there. And moving up scale or a little bit again there. Coming back down the scale. Pentatonic a little bit there. Then we're sort of pedaling, catching those two notes like that between the strings of 4th and 3rd. So you can tell there, we're moving primarily between the 4th and the 1st guitar strings. All straight time 16th notes. You can count them out to yourself in the beginning if you'd like. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. Now keep your hand loose and relaxed. If you're not loose and relaxed with it, you're probably going to get things gummed up in there, or you might get some hand pain or something. Be careful about that. So just work on the study till it feels really comfortable. Turn on a metronome. You know, have a first goal tempo of what's written on the page there. I got 63 beats per minute written as the first goal tempo. And then move it along the neck. You know, you could take it to different locations. Maybe take it into first position there. It's going to be a bit more challenging as you go down to the lower end of the neck where the frets become wider spaced. Just move it around, though. Really get good at your technique with it. Now, the next one we're going to move into is example number 2B. Here, the drill gets even more challenging because it's taking on another guitar string. So what we're doing in this one, it's written up at the E tone on the 5th guitar string at the 7th fret, and we're going to be moving off that, going 7, 9, 10 on that 5th string, then 7, 9 over to 7 on 3rd string, doubling back to 4th, then back to 3rd, going up more, catching some scale tones there all the way to 1st guitar string. Then we're going to drop down on 2nd string to wrap things up. You can see there 10, 8, and 7 are the last tones there. So it's a really good workout through the E minor scale. If you're familiar with the guitar programs that I've been putting out on the members area, that's the E minor scale pattern number 2. In the beginning, you know, when you're first learning it and you're memorizing the layout, count out the timing. It helps a lot. 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a. is a great way to get used to your scales. Move them along the neck, as we've been saying with the other studies. I'm going to move them to different locations. It's an excellent exercise. So that's exercise number 2B. And for the handout, you have to be a member, of course. So, you know, definitely sign up for your either your basic or your premium membership. Of course, the more popular membership is the premium membership because you have access to all the handouts and all of the MP3 jams for all the courses for introductory, intermediate, and advanced. So anyway, I will wrap things up at this point. We're going to take a short break. I will see you next in the members area, where we're going to get a chance to run through the third and fourth examples. We're going to do some legato ideas and even take things into the world string skipping as well. So I'll catch up with you next in the members area. Be sure to head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com for part two of this lesson in the members area. In part two, I'll be working through some legato drills using some hammer-on and pull-off exercises. And I'm also going to be spending some time on working through string skipping drills as well. It's going to be really helpful for your technique. Also, you want to keep in mind that with a membership, whether it's basic or the premium membership, you're going to have access to all of these masterclass handouts and the MP3 jam tracks that coincide with each lesson. So I'll catch up with you next in the members area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe to the Creative Guitar Studio YouTube channel and never miss another guitar lesson. Click here to sign up for your free membership to creativeguitarstudio.com. And if you take out a paid membership, you'll get premium content, downloads of jam tracks, lesson handouts, and full access to all the members area video lessons. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time for another guitar lesson. Bye for now. Head over to my blog site at andrewwasson.com for links to my daily blog posts, and be sure to follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, and subscribe to my other guitar blog YouTube channel. All the links are underneath in the show more description box of this video.